On the eighth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 8 maids a-milking,
7 swans a-swimming,
6 geese a-laying, 5 golden rings,
4 calling birds,
3 French hens,
2 turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the ninth day of Christmas, my true
love
gave...
Please stop! No more Christmas music!
I didn't realize we brought the Grinch along with us on our trip.
I agree with Petunia. Enough Christmas cheer already.
And the Grinch invited her buddy Scrooge.
Oswald, will you please just turn the radio on?
I've been trying, but we're too high up in the mountains.
Mammy, we're all tired and we're all bored.
Well, aren't we Miss Snippety today?
Oswald, I think this should be the last time we drive all this way for Christmas.
You know, I agree with Pete. The only reason I agree to come out here year after year is that little bit of hope that we might just get our hands on some of that hillbilly's money.
I agree. Besides, I miss Christmases at home in our warm beds and pajamas.
Watch that squirrel!
Pete, don't yell like that. I saw it.
Sorry.
But you three listen to yourselves. How selfish you sound.
Sorry, it's just that
these hillbillies, as you call them, Mimi, happen to be family.
But it's just that...
Family that think we, their city cousins, hung the moon.
But it's just that...
Our humble cousins who never ask anything from us except to spend a little extra time with them at Christmas. And all you three can think about is how to get your greedy little hands on some of their Uncle Zeke's inheritance. Which, by the way, he didn't leave you, but he did leave them.
But they have millions.
It's their money, Pete.
Watch out there!
I saw it!
But Oswald, you've always been the first one of us to try to get your hands on some of their fortune.
Okay, fine. I admit, in the past, I've been a little greedy, but I'm turning over a new leaf this year. No more will I ever try to con those sweet, lovable country folks out of their rightful millions. You three are my witnesses.
Watch out!
What was that?
Where did it go?
Was that what I thought it was?
It couldn't be. There's no such thing.
Oswald, what was it?
Maybe it was a bear.
Walking on two legs?
It must have been 8 feet tall.
Oswald, just get us out of here.
The car won't start.
Hurry, lock the door.
What was that?
Shh, quiet.
Mimi, I love you, and I'm sorry for anything I've ever done to you.
I've enjoyed all of our times together.
Hush!
Try the car again.
Okay. Look, everything's okay. I think it's gone. And look, right over there is the Cricket County line.
Howdy!
Ah!
I'm sorry about that. I didn't mean to scare you.
We didn't see you first.
The name's Winnie. This sure is a fancy-looking automobile you're driving on these slush-covered dirt roads.
We've driven in from the city to visit our cousins, the Taylors.
Well, I declare, me and your Grandma Taylor go way back.
What are you doing walking around on such a cold night holding a bow and arrow?
Oh, well, I was just on the hunt for something, but I better not tell you what it is. Don't want you city folk to get too scared, but I'd get somewhere safe real quick, like by y'all. Merry Christmas, Juniors.
Oswald, ask her about that creature we heard and saw.
Miss! Hey, where'd she go? Hello?
She was standing right there.
This is spooky. Oswald, get us out here.
You don't have to tell me twice.
Thank you.
there for, Rain. I can't wait to see what you've done with it.
Put your horses.
I wish you'd get yourself some mirrors in this place.
I got mirrors, Tallulah.
I mean the wall kind.
What do you think this is, New York City? Now hush up so I can get you done and move on to my next customer.
There ain't a soul within a mile of this place.
Well, Patsy Joe dropped off those two possums she ran over the other day. She's wanting me to stuff them so she can give them to Earl for Christmas. And honey, let me tell you, them is two of the ugliest creatures I ever saw.
Ugly, huh?
Oh, child, they are so ugly they make a blind man cry.
Oh, mama.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised if Death took one good look at them, sent them back, and they came through the door now.
Well, howdy, howdy, howdy.
Howdy, howdy, howdy.
Y'all, you're right, Flo. Those are the ugliest creatures I ever did see.
Howdy, Miss Lula.
Now, look, Emma, that's why she come to a beautician for.
Beautician nothing, she needs a mechanic.
What are you two no-accounts talking about over there?
I was just telling Elmer here how good Miss Delilah's hair's gonna look when you get finished with it.
What do you mean? I just got done.
You got on what?
Fixing Delilah's hair.
Miss Florine, you yanking my chain.
How does it look, Fester? She ain't let me see it yet.
Miss Florine.
Needs me in the back room. I'll be right back. Now,
you don't go peeking at that hair
till
I get back, Missy. Okay. Quick, Fester,
hand me that mirror over there.
I don't see none. It must all be broke.
Just hand it to me. She ain't let me see it yet.
I've seen better stuff in my shower drain.
Looks like this book cut her hair with the weed whacker.
Good heavens! Hand me that mirror!
If your husband leaves you, I know a girl that'll be glad to court you no matter what you look like.
Florine!
Now, Miss Tallulah, don't go crazy!
What are you yelling about?
My hair!
Come on, Elmer, I can't stand the sight of blood! Beautiful as a mud fence.
Well, what are you boys doing here?
Oh, well, we just come by to tell you something. Well, bye.
Fester.
Yeah?
You ain't told me nothing yet.
Oh. Elmer, what did we come by to tell Brenda May?
I can't remember. The bunny distracted me.
Oh, I remember. We just come by to tell you about, don't forget play practice at church tonight.
I'm the one that reminded you.
Ooh-wee, it's getting cold up there.
Well, let's go, Elmer.
Fester, what time is it?
Well, you wearing a watch?
Oh, yeah. So, Fester, what time is it?
It's time you learn how to tell time.
I gotta go meet somebody.
You meeting Glenn May?
Nope. How do you meet Glenn May? Glenn May's my wife. I said I meet somebody. Well, by then.
Who in Sam Hill is that boy meeting this dog fired in court?
Maybe he's just meeting a friend.
Well, that can't be, because I'm the only friend he's got. Well, holler at y'all hens later.
Fester Taylor. What have I told you about calling us
him? I'm sorry, Grandma. That's what Cousin Elkin calls y'all when y'all ain't around.
Well, thanks a lot, you big dummy. Why don't you go slap a hog or something?
Speaking of hogs, that reminds me. I gotta go pick up that new pig that I bought at the flea market for Grandma's Christmas present.
You got me a new pig for Christmas, Fester?
Who told you?
Oh, Lord. I sure could use a new pig. I am just about taking it to the diner.
Oh, Grandma, you really gonna like this one. I got him dressed up in yeller overalls.
Why in the world would you dress a pig in yellow overalls?
Because he split the seams out of his blue ones.
Oh, me.
Oh, Rain, I come to fix that lace back here.
It's in the back room there, Elkin. Thank you much.
Miss Tallulah, your hair.
Well, thank you, Elkin.
That reminds me. Y'all hear about that big mess exploding off the coal mine? I reckon it's something.
Well, Brenda May, how's your first week of going at your new job?
Real good, Grandma. I only burnt off two ears and cut off both of her beard backs.
You cut off old Cliff's beard? Well, he's had that beard for 30 years.
Yeah, he wasn't too happy about it.
Well, sometimes my new girls just get a little scissor happy.
Imogene, what do you think about my hair?
It's like a chicken hawk's nest.
Don't worry.
Lorraine here will get you fixed up real good.
What do you mean fixed up? She just got finished with it.
Oh, well, in that case, it's
Do you mean it?
I mean it. I think it's pretty.
How pretty?
Open casket pretty.
That's more like it. Gotta look my best for the Christmas play tonight. Thank you so much, Flo.
See you later.
Bye!
Mercy, child. That woman sure likes big hair.
Oh, here she is. Merry Christmas.
Well, Merry Christmas. Y'all get up in there out of the cold. Oh, y'all didn't step on those possums on the front porch, did you?
I hope not.
I see you found my note.
Yes, ma'am. We went to your diner, saw your note, and came right over.
You must be the proprietor of Flo's Beauty Shop.
No, honey. I'm the owner. I'm a beautician by day and a taxidermist by night.
She ain't teasing hair. She's stuffing sawdust inside of a rope.
Oh, yeah. Back in Cricket County, all right. So classy.
Well, I'm Jean, honey. You going to introduce me?
Oh, I'm sorry, Flory. These here are my kinfolk from the city. This here's Ozzy.
Oswald. Oh, nice.
And that there's Peter. That one down there's Petunia. And little Moo Moo. She knows perfectly well that my name is Mimi. These here are our kinfolk on Zeke Taylor's side of the
family. Well, I've just heard so much about you.
Please do not believe a word of it.
Howdy, Cousins. Come on in and stay a while.
What, now, just until I get my hair done, then we're going to go over to the diner and I'll cook y'all up a good country supper.
Yes, ma'am.
Any of y'all want a haircut?
Brenda May, you're doing hair now?
Yep, started just this week.
Good heavens, they gave her a pair of scissors?
I didn't know you went to cosmetology school, Brenda May.
Well, that's because she didn't, honey. I do all of my training right here in my shop. The girls start out working on Fester's hair. Then they move their way up to the dogs. And then they move on to real people.
That's what I want to do for a living now.
Well, that's wonderful, Brenda May.
At least until that counter job at Darragat opens up. Now there's a career.
So, where's your identical twin that looks nothing like you?
She's on her way over now to pick me up. We got to cook Elmer some supper. We're going to play breakfast tonight.
How does Linda May like married life?
Just fine. She's just cooking and cleaning her little heart out.
But that's what she wanted, right? To get married and to set up housekeeping?
Yep. That's what she wanted, and that's what she's got.
But here lately, Elmer's been coming in late and getting told to her. She don't like that part of married life.
Honey, there's two times a woman don't understand a man. Before marriage and after marriage.
Bandy's out shooting big scary creatures on the side of the road.
Why does Elmer come in late?
Well, he says because he lost his watch, and Brenda May says you can't tell time, and Elmer says that what he meant was because he took his boat out for a ride on the lake, and Linda May says, well, we don't have a boat, and Elmer says what he meant was because his truck had a flat tire, and Elmer said, Linda May says, we don't have a truck. And Elmer says what he meant was because he had to go to the hardware store to buy dog food. And Linda May says, we don't have a dog.
Honey, we get the picture. You know, I've always said that men was slim pickings in Cricket County. And Elmer Crick is the slim pickings.
So, Imogene, what are we doing this week?
I want you to make me beautiful for the Christmas play on Sunday.
One mission impossible. Coming up. Brenda May, take Imogene back there and get her washed up for me, please.
Yes, ma'am. Come on, Grandma.
And be sure to empty that dirty mop water out of the sink and slide those deer hides over before you dunk her in this time.
Y'all get you a soda pop while you're waiting. I'm buying.
I'm gonna put these towels in the washing machine. Y'all make yourselves at home.
Actually, a soda sounds pretty good right now.
Wait, Pete, you're not actually going to drink out of that, are you?
Well, not now.
I'll never know for the life of me why I always wind up wearing my best outfits when we come out here to the country.
Who are you wearing today?
Donna Karen.
There's an
no one here to impress.
You're so spoiled.
You know, speaking of unlucky, I lost all the cash I had in that darn slot machine before we left.
When did you play the slots?
Before we left the city, while Oswald was gassing up the limo.
How much money did you lose?
All the cash I had. $10.
What'd you get for gambling?
Oswald, total them out, but your socks don't match.
Well, they sure don't, do they? Oh, well, I guess I've got another pair just like them at home.
You have my pity. A grown man who cannot even dress himself?
It's not my fault. My clothes are here, there, and everywhere. That's what happens when you move in with your neighbors.
Well, don't expect me to feel sorry for you when you're having your home redecorated for the third time.
And the last time, I might add. Living with my neighbors and their six kids has got the best of me. You know, a couple of days ago, the twins decided they wanted me to play dress up with them.
I saw the pictures.
What pictures?
The ones of you wearing makeup. They're on the internet.
There are pictures of me wearing makeup on the internet?
Don't worry. You look beautiful.
By the way, have y'all noticed my second BMW is missing in action?
You mean the car you promised me when the time was right?
Yes, that one.
What have you done with my car?
I sold it.
What? Why?
My friend Stan told me to put as much money as I could into SCNC. He said I could make a killing.
I'm getting ready to do some killing of my own. That's my car you sold.
My car.
Well, Pete, you and your get-rich-quick schemes.
SCNC is good, solid stuff.
This is just a peachy Christmas, isn't it? I'm homeless. Mimi lost all her money in a slot machine. Petunia's upset because she's wearing Donna Karen's clothing. And Pete sold his car to buy SCNC stock. Aren't we bringing Christmas cheer to Cricket County?
Believe me, there's not going to be any Christmas cheer at all. You know, unless we get our...
Do not even say it. We are not asking our country cousins for any of their inheritance money, and that's that. Oh, hello, Elkin. Merry Christmas.
Well, howdy, folks. Merry Christmas to you and yours.
We didn't see you standing there.
Well, I just come in, didn't hear say a pitiful thing you folks were talking about just then. Let me tell you, I'm mighty impressed how strong you're being in such a scary time as this.
Must have overheard us talking about that creature we saw on the side of the road.
Yes, Elkin, that was a very scary thing that happened to us.
Well, of course it's scary. It would be to anybody. But don't forget what the good book says. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Psalms 23 and verse 4. And everybody say
amen.
Amen.
How about this creature we saw?
Creature?
Yes, the one we saw on our way in. Have you seen it?
Oh, yeah, I've seen it.
Well, what is it, Elkin?
Well, don't rightly know. It started showing up about a week ago. We call it the Christmas creature, seeing how it showed up around Christmas time tonight.
Oswald, I'm scared.
Well, it's been scaring people all over the county. Poor Widow Sapley was slopping her hogs when she seen it behind her barn. Poor woman took out some pastures off the weed and run right out of the dirt.
How strange that it started showing up all of a sudden.
Well, sure is strange, but I guess a mysterious creature running around Cricket County is at least the out of trouble right now.
What do you mean?
It's a basic doggone brain specimen.
Now, about this creature we saw. I'm curious about this thing. Come on, Oswald. Let's go take a look for ourselves.
Might as well.
You two can't be serious. You can't go out there looking for that thing.
Well, it's just the past time until Grandma Taylor gets done with her hair.
I'm not going out there so some homegrown wild creature can have me for Christmas then.
Fine. Stay here and console Cousin Elkin. Something's really got him upset.
I think I'll go, y'all.
Okay, tell Grandma Taylor where we went.
Just a minute. Broke as they are, trying to pretend like nothing's a matter.
I sure will be glad when y'all get some hot water displaced. My head's numb from the ears up.
Sorry, Grandma.
What's wrong with you? You look like you lost your best friend.
Grandma, I got some bad news.
What happens, child? What is it?
Well, I don't know how to say it.
Try using your tongue.
Seems our city cousin is flat broke.
Broke?
Face is taller than that crab one. Right now.
That's crazy talk,
since
you know him. Our cousins live in big mansions in the city.
Well, I reckon they don't know more. They don't know I overheard them talking to them, though. And believe me, they's broke as a preacher in hard times. I heard Cousin Oswald say he was homeless. Cousin Mimi lost all her money investing in slot machines.
Slot machines?
You've all been thinking on that. And I reckon that's a fancy name for a dart killer.
Well, that makes sense. If they broke, they're probably having to grow their own food now.
That's what I was thinking, too. Anyway, it's hard to say, because Tanya had to borrow some clothes from a couple of friends of hers. I think her name is Donna and Karen. Well, your cousin Pete had to sell a car so they could buy SC&C stuff.
Well, what's
SC&C
stand for?
Well, I reckon that stands for sheep, cows, and chickens.
I do declare. And they have come all the way back out here to get their hands on some of our inheritance money.
Well, no, ma'am. That's the last thing Cousin Oswald told everybody. He said, no matter what, we are not asking our country cousins for any of their money. That's that.
What?
Well,
that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard
in
my whole life.
Well, sure enough, broke you seriously, though,
lad. I heard that creature Tar statue just play dead. They're out there looking for that Christmas creature. Oh, Grandma, I love what you done your hair.
Honey, I'm wearing a towel.
Well, it sure does suit you. Brenda May, are you ready? I really do need to get out for supper starting.
Yep, girl, here's my last customer.
What I'd like to know is how it could happen to the nicest folks in the whole world.
What's wrong, Cousin Elkin?
Go ahead and tell her.
Well, you see,
Cousin Elkin overheard some bad news. Go ahead and tell her, Cousin Elkin.
Well,
you see, it seems our city, you know, once in the city, well, it seems they're dirt poor.
Poor?
Poor.
How poor?
Instead of sitting down to supper, they just read recipes.
They eat
salad. Well, y'all stop it with the corny country saying, this is serious.
I just can't believe my ears.
Well, I wouldn't believe it either if I hadn't heard it for myself.
They're selling their houses, their clothes, their cars.
It makes me so sad.
Everything's going to be all right.
Y'all drive that fancy car of yours over to the diner. Let yourself in.
And I'll be over there just as soon as I get finished here. And y'all help y'all to anything in that kitchen. And I do mean anything. Y'all eat and eat and eat till your little tummies just can't hold it no more.
Okay, we appreciate it. We haven't eaten anything all day.
We haven't eaten anything all day!
Sure is strange.
Oh, bring the mate. I love it. It's just what I wanted.
Oh, wait, I'm a chain. It is you.
Grandma, I liked your hair better the other way.
Hush up, everybody. I got everything figured out. After the play at church, we'll sneak over here and throw a big surprise party for the city folks.
Oh, that's a great idea.
What's everybody doing in here? Don't y'all realize that creature could attack at any minute? It's done broke into 3 houses and scared 4 cats up some trees. It's run high fast in Creature County.
Winnie, honey, what are you rambling about?
Where's them city folk at? Them scared cats done run back to the city, didn't they?
Well, no, honey. They're over at the diner.
Well, if they know what's good for them, they'll hightail it out of here real quick like.
Hey! If you was to come across a wandering pig, can you hold on to him for me?
She's so upset about that Christmas tree.
Where in the world do you think that come from?
Now, we ain't got time to worry about that. We got to get focused on this surprise.
I tell you what, let's all go to the back room and we can sit around my taxidermy table and do us some landing.
Our cousins are going to be so surprised, aren't they, Brenda Mae?
They sure will, Brenda Mae. Because what if we stay in the country? When God closes the door, he opens up the window.
Listen until the flies start coming in. Then he might suggest closing the window and
lock the door. It's about time everybody got out of my way. Is
everybody gone? Get in here, Elmer.
Glenn and Mae is starting to ask a lot of questions, and that makes me more nervous than a tickle dip day.
Sit down, boy. If you keep acting nervous, like you'll spill the beans for sure. Where's the scary man?
I hid it in the hollow tree out back.
Well, go get it. That creature needs to make another appearance. We ain't got no time to lose. So keep quiet and listen.
Shepherd part in the play tonight.
Fester, Christmas just wouldn't be Christmas without your watching their flocks by night sing.
I reckon it's the best they ever did. And there, in the same country, shepherds abiding in the fields, watching their flocks by night.
So now, Fester, I sure hope everybody gets here for the city folk, dude.
Well, the plan is supposed to keep them over the church after everybody gets over here.
Grandma, you want the wise shepherd to look out for him?
That's a good idea, Fester. Where do you reckon we might find one?
Commit me!
Be quiet. We want this to be perfect.
Everybody give me your presents you have given to the city folk.
Well, I guess mine is ready, Grandma.
And the canned foods are in the back room in a box.
Well, these presents sure ain't very big.
Well, Grandma, sometimes big things come in small packages. Take my brain, for example.
Honey, somebody took your brain a long time ago.
Well, what I mean is that my brain's real big and it's packed real tight in my noggin, not leaving much wiggle room.
And my scarecrow out in the cornfield, his head is stuffed tight with straw, but he's still just a dummy.
My point exactly. Take baby Jesus, for example.
Well,
he was to become the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, God's only son to save the whole world from her sin. But he came as a tiny baby, a great big God come in such a tiny, tiny patch.
Well, you can't argue with him there, Grandma.
This is my gift for him. It's a lifetime supply of haircuts and hairdos right here in my shop.
Oh, it's the gift that just keeps on giving.
Well, here they come.
What? They're early. Everybody hide. Surprise!
Oh, that's so sweet, y'all.
You said it was the city bunch.
No, ma'am. I said, here they come. You made up the rest on your own.
Good heavens. Keep watching and don't say, here they come like that.
Yes, I'm going to shade my eyes like I did in the playtime.
Friend of mine, y'all was supposed to be keeping the city bunch over at the church house till everybody could get here.
They won't be getting here anytime soon, Grandma.
How you know?
We let the air out of all four tires.
Good thinking.
By the way, has anybody saw Elmer?
Well, he ain't with you.
No. He told me he was going to meet me outside the church house after the play. When I got out there, he's plumb gone.
Glendamine, everybody in the whole county but you knows there's something strange going on with that boy.
Grandma, I can't help but he's just a little simple-minded.
Simple man is right. Elmer's 20 years old before he realized farm wasn't spelled E-I-O.
But I'm talking extra strange. And all these excuses he's been coming up with for being late for supper and things like that.
Grandma, between you and me, and the fence post, and the mailbox that there happens to be on the side of the fence post, and the snake that sometimes shows up in the mailbox, because he likes dark places.
Hey!
Between me and him, I think he's just excited about giving me my Christmas present.
If that's what you think it is, I'm sure you're right.
Fester, why didn't you tell us somebody was coming?
You told me not to.
Is it who I think it is?
Yes, sir.
Everybody,
somebody get the dope.
I will.
Is your yeast ever going to rise?
Elmer, what happened to your nose?
I was running and tripped over a tree in the front yard.
Which one?
The only front yard you got. It was hard to see through all the...
Sit right here. Let me look at it.
It hurt so bad, Linda May.
It was hard to see through the what, Elmer?
It was hard to see through all the fog out there.
There ain't a bit of fog.
Somebody just drove up.
Is it who I think it is?
Well, who do you think it is?
The city folk!
Bingo! No, I just found an old bingo card over here. Bingo!
Well, then hurry up and
hide. Are you sure it was them, Fester?
Yes, I'm pretty sure. I shepherdize, they sharp as tacks.
Y'all be quiet. We don't want them to know we're hiding.
Who are we hiding from?
The city bunch.
Why are we hiding from the city bunch?
Because we want a surprise and a hush up.
Well, I hope they sure don't see us hiding.
Hey.
Cousin Oswald, would you please put a lock on it?
Cousin Oswald? Grandma?
What, honey?
Love you.
No! Where in the Sam Hill did y'all come from?
The back room.
That just burned me cornbread.
Surprise!
What's all this about?
Well, it's a surprise party for y'all.
Well, at least they were surprised. Just like the shepherds, the night the angels came and told them the baby Jesus was born. The angels yell, "Surprise!"
The gospel according to Fester. All I can say is there better be some gifts associated with this according.
Oh, there he is, cousins. There he is.
What's the occasion?
What y'all heard? Y'all's poor.
Fester, zip your lip. We just thought it was high time we showed our sister cousins how much we appreciate them. That's all.
Yeah, someone started this coming.
There we go. Are y'all comfortable?
Y'all sure did get your flat tire sticks off the quick light.
What flat tire?
The ones we let the air out.
Uh-oh, mate. We must have decompressurized the wrong tire.
Why don't drive an old red pickup truck covered in rust butts, do you?
No, we don't like to be.
Be quiet. It doesn't matter. They said we were getting gifts.
Miss Flo, where did you get your Christmas tree?
Isn't that the tree from the church?
Oh, by the way, we really enjoyed the Christmas program this evening.
Yes, it was better than any play we've ever seen in New York City.
That's nice. Ain't that nice, Fester?
Mm-hmm. As I was saying, we thought it was high time we showed our city cousins how much we appreciate and love.
I like where this is going.
And we showed you just how much.
What Elkin is trying to tell y'all through all that blubbering is that we think it's high time that we showed y'all.
We showed y'all just how much we care about you.
Well, maybe I ought to start off here. I know I'm not family, but like everybody else here in Christie County, I wanted to make a
contribution. I really like where this is going.
What
are you
doing?
Here you go.
A gift certificate for a lifetime supply of haircuts and hairdos, courtesy of Flo's Beauty Shop and Taxidermy. One location worldwide.
That's right, nurse. I can make your hair as high as you want. The sky is the limit.
Collection. I started it when I was 5 years old. I remember that year that well. It's the same summer I learned to walk. Please call me Wise Shepherd. Oh yeah, here's something a little extra.
Thank you, Fest. Wise Shepherd.
It's my part of Uncle Zeke's inheritance.
Uncle Zeke's inheritance? Fester, you're giving us your old thing?
Hell, I'm sorry. It's just a little one. For the life of me, I can't get that thing quit spewing that old nasty oil out of the ground.
Fester, they've been drilling in that field for years now.
I know it, and I'm a little embarrassed to say it. It still ain't clean. But if y'all just be patient, one of these days that old field will dry up. We can do some mighty fine dove shooting.
Heck, I'll just talk to y'all nice folks.
Fester, isn't that field worth millions?
That's what they tell me. I'm sorry it couldn't be worth more.
for me.
It's a lifetime supply of eating at my humble little diner. Once y'all move out to Cricket County, y'all gonna need some good old-fashioned vittles in your bellies.
I'm sorry. You said move to Cricket County?
Oh, and I almost forgot. There's the coal mines that Uncle Zeke left me. I'm sure if you want to go to the trouble of moving all that coal out, there'll be enough in there to last you for several winters ahead.
Grandma Taylor, I couldn't.
Not by yourself, you couldn't, but there'll be plenty of men around here.
I love my wife so much. I didn't ask for her, but she's giving me $3 million.
Friend May, Lady May, Chelsea.
I got $3 a year for the next 1 million.
True enough, Grandma. These is from the both of us.
Oh. Lady May, Lady May, you really, really, really shouldn't have.
Oh, look, Petunia. Some plain old ordinary hand-me-down run-of-the-mill cotton dresses. Yay.
Bring me the card.
Oh, yeah. Dress was the main thing, but here's a little something extra.
Oh, look, it's a poem. To our lovely city cousins, we've known you for a few short years, but it seems like dozens. May God bless you on his day of birth. To him and us, you are worth millions. Merry Christmas.
What's this?
Let me see. Glenda May, you're giving us your part of Uncle Zeke's inheritance, too?
Just a couple of diamonds over across the ridge.
Yeah, it's just shot full of diamonds. Good gracious, what's a couple hillbillies like us gonna do with a big hole inside of a mountain like that?
Girls, we can't accept
Oswald, this. Be quiet! Don't you know that diamonds are a girl's best friend?
Maybe so, but gingham is a girl's lifelong love.
Glenda might sure like some gingham dresses.
Last but not least, there you go.
It's a picture of a rustic cabin.
Are you ready? Right there is your brand new home that we're done with and built.
Our home?
For the last 3 days, about 40 men here in Cricket County gave you and your family your very own rustic cabin with 2 outhouses and a freshwater lake. Merry Christmas. Oh, yeah. That's there just a little extra.
You're giving us your part of Uncle Zeke's inheritance, too.
Well, mine's a great big old field. It makes Fester look like a bottle of ink.
Well, do you all realize what you've just done? You've given us every cent of Uncle Zeke's inheritance.
Well, Uncle Zeke would have wanted it that way. He always taught us to share with the least fortunate.
Psalm 41, verse 1. Blessed is he who considers the poor. The Lord will deliver him in times of trouble.
Excuse me. Did he just refer to us as poor?
Elk and Grandma Taylor, will you excuse us for just a moment? We need a second to take all of this in. If you just want to...
I'm sitting right over here with a bloody nose of Benny if anybody wants to talk to me.
Okay. Which one of you was it?
What do you mean?
It's obvious that one of you's been trying to get his or her hands on their inheritance.
Oswald Tippenham, we have done no such thing.
Listen here. I may be rude, obnoxious, and a little highbrow, but one thing I am not is a fibber. I have not said one thing about all that money. Scout's honor.
The very idea.
The irony of it all, the 1 year we decide not to ask them for any money, they give us every last cent they have.
I'm getting to the bottom of this. Elkin. Don't you see that giving us all this means we'll be dirt poor again?
Well, no man is poor when he has his God, health, family, and friends.
In that case, we'll take it.
Pete!
Be nice chewing a fat with you, but it's kind of getting interesting over here.
Fester's scripture just now.
Whose scripture?
Sorry, the wise shepherd's scripture just now. Blessed is he who considers the poor. What made you all think we were poor?
Elton told us.
Well, you ain't got to pretend with us no more. We know all about you had to move out of your fancy house in the city.
And we know all about little Moo Moo losing all of her money invested in the garden killer.
That's what this is about. Look, this was a big, huge misunderstanding. I moved out of my house in the city so it could be refurbished.
That means torn down.
Wise shepherd, it means remodel.
Exactly. And I still have two other cars.
And my clothes are designed by Donna Karen.
Alas, I did lose all my money in that darn slot machine.
Me.
Okay, it was only $10.
You must have overheard us talking and misunderstood.
So wait a minute. Let me get this straight. Y'all ain't seen my lost pig nowhere.
Look, y'all just take back all of your inheritance, everything. Y'all just take it all back. And everything will be just fine and back to normal.
Elton Taylor, how on earth did you get everything mixed up?
Grandma, it was an honest mistake. Look, it's a beautiful, snowy Christmas Eve. Let's just celebrate together.
Well, that sounds like a good idea. Let's start out by singing a shepherd song. While shepherds watch their flocks by night,
all seated on the ground,
the angel of the Lord came down.
Who in the sand could that be?
I'll get it. He won't even let me sing. Watch. It's just that Christmas creature. What?
Why in the world did you do it?
You really want to know why?
Because of them.
Us?
Well, I'll come up with a little plan for you. Here you are. Read a little hand on it.
Winnie, honey, listen.
I was just trying to watch out for my neighbor to protect you from the likes of them.
Now listen here, I've had just about enough.
It's okay.
Well, Miss Winnie, you got it all wrong. Our city cousins come out here for a friendly visit, that's all.
Yeah, they proved you not by giving us back our inheritance.
Elmer Creek, I trust you this whole time, you little rascal.
It doesn't surprise me at all that Elmer did what he did. I happen to know a bit of scripture myself. The righteous gives and does not hold back. You see, Cricket County is full of givers. In fact, these people were so overflowing with giving that they had nothing left for themselves.
That's right. And Glenda May gave Elmer her trust. She never doubted for one time that he was loyal to her.
Elmer gave her his time so Glenda May would have a special gift for Christmas.
Miss Florine gave of her talent, which would have taken money right out of her own pocket.
Miss Winnie gave her protection because she thought her friends could be hurt by someone else's grief.
And Elkin gave a little bit of everything we just mentioned so that we, his cousins of the only seas once per year, would be taken care of.
Speaking of giving, you know why when you know, like for being a part-time preacher job?
Is the sky blue? Is the grass green? Is your teeth yellow?
It's not my couple did it.
Poor Elmer Crick, he makes me look like Albert Einstein.
Elmer Crick, get out of that costume. We don't have to do that no more. Did somebody call me?
Look, there really is a Christmas creature. And he's got pork chop. Get yourself in here, you pig thief.
All right,
sir,
get back here.
Can't we just have one Christmas without a little charity?
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Push the button when you're ready. Let's start with it.
Cousin Elkin is Chris Lawson. days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, under the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared.
And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Son, and he died for our sins. And so, you know, us don't forget.